thank you for watching another MuggyWeld.com video, and make sure to hit the subscribe button. We are demonstrating how to solder a seam on two pieces of copper. You can add the flux cold or after the copper has been heated with a flame or heat gun. Just wait for the liquid flux to turn brown, then add the rod. Just like that. Now we're going to work the seam. The flux will make the solder adhere to the copper, help seal pressurized systems, and works as an absolute temperature guide. The Super Alloy 1 rod melts at 350 degrees Fahrenheit. You can get to that temperature very quickly, especially on thin pieces. The color change of the Super Alloy 1 flux tells you where you are in the soldering process and should give you a better result. It looks like our flux is telling us to add the low temperature solder. One major advantage to using the Super Alloy 1 is the solder is in rod form, which makes running a seam much easier, as you can see right there. After allowing the copper to air cool, we use warm water to remove the flux residue. Sometimes you want to hide the appearance of the solder. Here's an easy technique. Add the flux to one part, heat like always, and add a small amount of Super Alloy 1 rod. Then add a drop or two to the other part. Place on top and heat until you see the flux turn brown. That's it. Metal artists and others like to hide the solder to give their project a cleaner look while adding more strength than glue or epoxy can provide. The Super Alloy 1 works on galvanized steel, stainless steel, aluminum, brass, mild steel, of course you saw it on copper, and many more in any combination. And heat-freeze heat absorption paste is a must when soldering next to heat-sensitive areas. That's the Super Alloy 1 Rod and Flux from MuggyWeld.com. And don't forget to tell a friend to Muggy Weld it!